Leaving Danville, the 611 heads south. The Jays pulling an excursion sponsored by the Bluegrass Railroad Museum over the Southern Railway between Lexington, Kentucky and Chattanooga, Tennessee. At Oakdale, Tennessee, the 611 made a brief stop for a crew change. Oakdale is one of two crew change points between Lexington and Chattanooga, the other being at Danville, Kentucky. Thank you. It's a 3-mile climb out of the Emory River Valley to Lansing, Tennessee, and the grades are fairly steep, 1.1%. But the big 484 handled the hill easily until it got near the top. Norfolk and Western's Class J number 611 is the sole surviving member of a group of 14 484s built in the Roanoke shops between 1941 and 1950. Put into service in May of 1950, the 611 and her younger sisters 612 and 613 were the last steam passenger engines built in the U.S. But their birth so late in the steam era certainly didn't make them weak competitors in the field of steam power. The Class J's were the most powerful 484s ever built, rated at 80,000 pounds tractive force. And they weren't lacking in the speed department either. The engines were counterbalanced so well that their small 70-inch drivers were capable of turning an incredible 540 RPM, this occurring on a test run over the Pennsylvania Railroad when one of the J's reached a speed of 110 miles per hour while pulling a 15-car train. The J's black and Tuscan red streamlining was designed by Frank C. Noel of the N&W's passenger car department, who admitted to being influenced by the designs of the New York Central's Hudsons and the Southern Pacific's Daylights. And the J's certainly made a beautiful sight, heading up the Tuscan red consists of the Powhatan Arrow, the Pocahontas, and other N&W varnish. We've seen the J at rest in the yard at Chattanooga. Now let's head south to the Southern's Crescent Division and pick her up several miles north of Etowah, Alabama, rolling down Little Wills Valley at 60 miles an hour. This portion of our program was taped during a round-trip excursion between Birmingham and Chattanooga, sponsored by the Heart of Dixie chapter of the NRHS. Now we're in southern Ohio, and the J is pulling the Independence Limited on a run from Alexandria, Virginia to Detroit, Michigan, via Roanoke, Bluefield, Williamson, Cincinnati, and Muncie, Indiana. This trip was sponsored by the Roanoke chapter of the NRHS and took place between July 21st and 24th of 1984. If you reduce the length of this train to only six or seven cars, it would bear a marked resemblance to the N&W's Powhatan Arrow of pre-Amtrak days. Introduced in 1946, this coach train was furnished with brand new streamline equipment in 1949. The consist included a mid-train diner and a lounge observation on the end. Passengers in 1958 could board number 25 at 7 a.m. in Norfolk and be in Cincinnati, 677 miles to the west, at 10:45 that evening. The schedule for eastbound number 26 was similar, leaving Cincinnati at 8:10 a.m. and arriving in Norfolk just before midnight. And your round-trip fare in those days would have been a whopping $40.70.